Good afternoon, everyone. This is Christy with Van Auto Company. It's Thursday, August 31st. I'm going to go over the markets here for the day for you. So first time we've seen some strength into these grain markets in a long time. So you had corn market up 12 to 13 cents, bean market up 13 to 14 cents, support into Chicago and Kansas City wheat, but Minneapolis wheat actually a bit lower, down about 17 cents. So a couple reasons why we think this market rallied, beginning with the fact that yesterday for majority of areas was when you had to get your old crop corn priced out for DP grain. So that was just a lot of selling pressure over the last 4 days of people that have been hauling in grain, specifically corn on DP, and giving themselves some time thinking you'd see this corn market come back. Didn't come back, and they were forced to sell here over the last 4 days. And so that put a lot of pressure on the market. Second thing, you have this cold building into the Eastern Corn Belt, and it's been there for a while, and it seems to intensify in the 6 to 10 day forecast. The 8 to 14 day forecast remains cold as well. You're starting to pick up that talk of just how delayed this crop is and how a freeze would impact these grain markets huge, and that you potentially could see one. The market's probably going to still take a wait and see mentality, but it's getting a little bit more real right now. And the third thing, it looked like there was quite a bit of spreading between Minneapolis wheat and everything else. So long Minneapolis wheat, short corn, long Minneapolis wheat, short beans. And it looked like that kind of flipped today. So a lot of selling into Minneapolis wheat, but the strength everywhere else. So those could be your top three reasons probably why you saw some support in here. We're going to see if we can confirm this support here tomorrow. We did bottom out the corn market last year on this exact day, so it'll be interesting to see how we follow suit going forward from here. Meat markets looked like they were going to come back for a little bit of strength into cattle, but couldn't hang on to it once corn got up and running. So both live cattle and feeder cattle a little bit on the lower side. Lean hogs though up about 85 cents. Outside markets really had some big strength in the crude market, unleaded gasoline with the problems going on in Texas. So you had strength there, strength in the US dollar or US Dow, but the US dollar started to fade throughout the day after being up hard yesterday, came back about 15 cents today, so no major move really there. Moving forward, what we're gonna be watching tomorrow, see if we can confirm this strength, and then also see what managed money has done from last Tuesday to Tuesday. We will get that here after the close tomorrow. I do have to close with the disclaimer. Trading in futures and options involves risk loss and may not be suitable for all producers. Have a great day.